हेलो, वेलकम टू द लेक्चर सीरीज प्रेजेंटेड बाय सेंट एंड्रयूज इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी एंड मैनेजमेंट. वी आर डिस्कसिंग द सब्जेक्ट कॉल्ड ऑब्जेक्ट टेक्नोलॉजीज एंड प्रोग्रामिंग इन जावा, दैट इज OTP इन जावा. ओके, एंड इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी आर डिस्कसिंग, वी हैव स्टार्टेड डिस्कसिंग अबाउट अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक, वेरी पॉपुलर टॉपिक कॉल्ड interface. Now in last lecture we have already seen how to implement a particular interface, how to use it, okay, and what is the basic idea behind creating the interfaces. Now in today's lecture we'll go in some minute details or some advanced topics in interfaces, how multiple interfaces can be used and some other stuff. So we'll try to finish this particular topic in today's lecture called interface. Let's begin. Okay. Now in last lecture we have seen, we have implemented this particular project in which we have created an interface called MySeries, and we have defined three fields, that is three methods. First is a method called getNext, which return you an integer value and doesn't take any arguments. Second is a method called restart, which doesn't return any value, that is its return type is void and doesn't take any arguments either. And last method called start, which accepts an argument called x and doesn't return you anything. Now the main idea behind what I am trying to implement here is, the main idea behind implementing or creating this particular interface is, we are trying to create an interface which results in an application which can print a series. Now it could be like 2 and 4 and 6 and 8 and 10, or let's say 3 and 6 and 9 and then 12 and so on. So we have two series with us. First, increments at each step by 2, and the second increment at each step by 3. Or you can have 4, 5, 6, 8. So as we have discussed, the main idea behind interfaces is to tell you, or to tell the application, or to tell the creators of an application that what must be done. But it doesn't tell you how it must be done or how it should be done. And in last lecture we have seen only one application, that is we have created this particular class called MySeries, which implements this particular interface that we have discussed just a second ago by using the keyword called implements. And we have implemented all the three methods with same signature in this particular class, and then we instantiated this particular class and tries to print. Okay, now today I'll try to implement this particular interface in some other class. And then we will see the difference of how an idea can be manipulated in two ways. Keep in mind that interface is just an idea. How you are going to execute that particular idea is entirely up to you. So I have implemented this particular idea in this class by creating a series which looks something like this. And now I will try to implement same idea, but this time I will try to put up the functionality which implements the same idea as the interface, but try to bring out the output, something like this. Okay, so I have already created a class. Now this class has been named as By2. It implements the interface called my series. Okay, now if we have to implement a particular interface, then we are bounded to include all the three methods and provide the method body to all the methods that are there in the interfaces. That is, if we have three methods in this particular interface, then we are bounded to include all these three methods in our class body if that particular class is implementing that particular interface. Okay, so we have done that. We have implemented all the three methods that are being defined in the interface with same signature, mind you. With same signature, we have only added an access modifier that is called public. And let me remind you again that. Okay, now we have only added one access modifier called public, and let me remind you that this particular access modifier public is by default in this interface, so we are doing nothing new here. Okay, and in this particular implementation of the interface, I have changed the functionality of the idea called get next. This time at each and every step, I'm adding two instead of three. See the difference? I'm adding two instead of three. Okay, so we have an idea. We have one type of implementation in this class, and of same idea, we have another implementation. Let's try to see if that second idea works or not. So I will first make an object. Okay, let's say my2 equal to new, and my2 and okay. Space there, and that is it. So again, try to implement that using the for loop that we have done in the last lecture. For, let's say, int j equal to 0 and j is less than 10, and let's say j plus plus, and system print n, and my2, so I've called the object. Okay, my2 dot and get next. That is it now for the time being. No, okay, we'll try to implement both of these methods. Let me remind you again, the name of the methods are same, but both of them are called by a different set of objects. So let's see what will happen. Okay, first 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18, 21, 24, 27, 30. Now this up to this line is the series that has been printed for this particular implementation. Okay. And from here on, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, and 20, this particular implementation is a result of this particular idea, the implementation of the idea. Okay, so you can see we have two methods, same name, that belongs to same interface, that is you can call it, it's same idea, but we have two different implementations of same idea. Now this is an example of polymorphism. This is polymorphism in action for you using interfaces. Okay, so let's move ahead. Sorry. Okay, now we'll have some minor details about the interfaces. One thing that we have left yesterday is the variables in interfaces. Okay, so you can always add some variables to the interfaces, but the catch is those variables will always be static and final. Okay, and public, that is by default. So basically these constants are actually these variables are actually behaving like constants. Now you can argue that what's the use of using these kind of variables when we can't change the value of these variables because they are practically constants. So you can these kind of variables find their applications in very large apps, in very large projects where we do not want our few of the things to change even by mistake by any of the other classes that are going to implement a particular interface. So if you have a huge project with let's say several hundreds of classes and they are implementing a particular interface, and if by mistake some coder tries to by mistake he change a particular value that must not be changed, or if it is being changed it will completely change the behavior of that particular method, so we don't want that. So in that case those variables which should not be changed even by mistakes are normally being created inside the interfaces, and they are always, they will always be static, final and public. So keep that thing in mind. The methods inside the interfaces are not static, they are only public, but variables are will always be static, final and public. Okay. Now one more thing that you can do is can create one more interface, and I will name it as, let's say, your series. Okay, I finished that. Now this your series interface is there, and let me create a particular method called, let's see, print val, and also okay, that is it. Now what I am trying to display here is that an interface can use help of another interface. So you can always write extends your series. So this particular interface called my series is actually using the interface called your series. Your series has a method now called print val. My series has added three more methods called get next, restart, start. Now any of the classes which are going to implement this particular interface. This particular interface will have to include all the ideas from all the interfaces that are in the chain. That is, this particular class must include all the three methods that are being defined here and the method that is being defined here. Okay, so an interface actually takes help of another interface. So we had an accumulation of ideas, few from the higher order interface and then the other interface, and then all the classes that are going to take those ideas and try to implement those ideas in its own way will have to implement all those ideas that are in both of the interfaces. That is what I'm trying to display. And mind you, when an interface use an interface, it uses its tense. Okay. So what if you try to use implements? We don't always use tense. So let's stop it here. Let's move on. Now, one more topic left, according to our syllabus, is the difference between abstract classes and the interfaces. Now, we have seen abstract classes in our last unit. So abstract classes are more or less similar to interfaces. They also provide you with methods with no implementation at all. Okay, but why we have to use interfaces when we have abstract classes with us? So abstract, first let me again recap some of the points with abstract classes. In abstract classes, we always provide the ideas like we have done in the interfaces, where try to define the signature of the methods, and we'll try not to include any implementation of those methods in the abstract classes. Let me remind you again, as like interfaces, abstract classes cannot be instantiated. That is, abstract classes cannot be instantiated. That is, you cannot make an object or create an object out of an interface or out of any abstract class. Okay, you know, these abstract classes can only be extended, and the main difference is when you extends an abstract class, it is not bounded by you to implement all its methods. Okay, while in interfaces, if you try to implement an interface in a particular class, it is an obligation of the class to include all the methods that are being defined in the interface and add its own method body or functionality. Second difference is, in while using abstract classes, you can create variables there which are non-static and non-final. Non-static and non-final. Let me remind you again, in the interfaces, all the variables are static and final. So if you want to use some of the variables that are that should be non-static and non-final, you can use them or you can create them in abstract classes. But if these particular variables are created inside the interfaces, they must be static and final and public. Okay. Okay. What else is left? One last thing is that we can also use that we can also use the reference variable as an interface. So I can always, let's say for time being I'm not doing this. So we can use my C. So you can see we have tried to create the object of class by3 and by2. Let me remind you again, both of these classes are implementing an interface called myseries right here. Now the name of the objects or the type of the object is not of the class but of the interface. So we can use always interface reference variables. Okay, you can always use that. Now this particular object here by3 is of type myseries, and this particular object called my2 is of type myseries. But when we are going to implement the method with same name dot get next and get next, what is going to be implemented will clearly be defined the associativity of the object with the class by which it has been instantiated. So type can be of the interface. Okay, but its associativity with the class will define its functionality. We'll see that again. Its associativity with the class will define its functionality. So we'll always keep that thing in mind. Okay. And one last thing. Can we do something like if a class has been created, can it implement an interface and extend a class at the same time? So the question is, can a class implements an interface and extends a class at the same time? So the answer is yes, we can do that. And how will you do that? The syntax will go something like keyword class small, and let's say the name of the class be C, and then extends and superclass called B, and then implements an interface called A, and then the body of the class will follow. Let me remind you, or let me put some pressure on these two keywords. The order of these two keywords is very important. Implements cannot precede extends. Let me remind you that again. Implements cannot precede extends. So first you have to use the keyword extend. That is, first it has to, the class has to extend a particular superclass, and then if it tries to implement a particular interface, it can do that. And why it is so? Because the compiler, when try to create a bytecode of a particular class, will always first look for its all the superclasses. and after that it looks for all the ideas that that class has tried to implement. So when compiler will reach here, that is class C, it will first look all the superclasses of class C. Okay, and if those classes, those superclasses are behind that interfaces, it will get confused. And one more thing is that we haven't discussed, let me discuss that again. A class can implement more than one interface. Let me remind you that again. A class can implement more than one interface at a time. Now, if we have two interfaces, one is called A and other is called B, you can add both of these interfaces to class C by just inserting a comma in between the names. So it will go something like this. So now this class C is extending a mother class called B, and it's implemented two interfaces. One is called A and other one is called B. Okay, remind you that again. Now this particular class C has to implement all the methods of interface A and all the methods of interface B. That is an obligation. We have no we cannot have loose ends. Okay, so that is all for the interfaces. We have seen what is the difference between the abstract classes and the interfaces, when to use them, and about the interfaces in detail, interfaces in action, how we can demonstrate polymorphism using interfaces, how we can use a class to be extended or class being extended by a mother class, and implementing one or more interfaces at the same time. So that is it. I'm going to end this lecture now, and if you have any doubts, you can always reach me on your class groups. Thank you.